Hello everyone, we are starting with our module 4, okay? And in module 4, we are basically going to learn about control systems, okay? Now in control systems, there are various things that I've already told you when we started with our first module. One of the topic is open loop control system, okay? You already know. What do you mean by open loop control system? Okay, open loop control system means no feedback. It takes the signal, it processes the signal, like signal comes, processed, okay, and signal is out. Okay, this kind of system is called as open loop control system. Okay, where there is no feedback. Another type of control system is closed loop control system. If you try to remember what happens in closed loop control system, it will be exactly opposite to that of open loop, where there will be a feedback. What do you mean by feedback? If the output is not desired, okay, you're taking an input, that input is getting processed, okay. After the processed, if the output is not desired, undesired kind, okay, which needs to be rectified, okay, or you can say rectified, what you need to do is there will be a feedback loop, okay. What will this feedback do? This feedback will tell the input to change the input, okay, change in input. There will be some change in input. And with this change in input, the processing of that input will happen and we will see whether we have got the desired output or not. If desired output is received, it will be done. Okay. But if it is not desired, it will again go back to this feedback loop. Okay. And then again, there will be a change in input. This process will keep on repeating and repeating and repeating. This kind of system is called as closed loop control system. Okay. I've already told you. At the initials only, what do you mean by open loop and what do you mean by closed loop control system? Okay. Today what we are going to do is, rather than studying open loop and closed loop, we will try to study what do you mean by transfer function. Okay. And what is block diagram? Okay. We will also study what are the rules for block diagram, and we will study block diagram reduction. Okay, how to reduce block diagram, why to reduce, we'll see it later. Initially we will see what do you mean by block diagram reduction, or you can even say block diagram algebra, because we use basic algebra techniques to reduce a block. Okay, now I'll tell you. We'll start with what do you mean by a transfer function, okay? Now, if we remember sensitivity, okay? If we remember sensitivity, suppose this is output and this is input. Sensitivity is nothing but change in output to change in input, right? And if this is constant, this is called as linear, okay? And these things will be called as, when there is a constant thing, then this thing is called as sensitivity. Sensitivity of the instrument should be linear. When the sensitivity of the instrument is not linear, then that sensitivity is called as transfer function. Rather than having a linear output to input ratio, I'll just write it. Rather than having a linear output to input ratio, okay, that is in case of sensitivity, okay, what we are going to have is, we will have non-linear, it can even be linear, okay, or linear output to input ratio. that is called as transfer function. If I want to tell you in a basic term, then transfer function is a more general term to define sensitivity. Okay, transfer function is a general term to define sensitivity. Okay, it is more like processing also. Okay, transfer function is a more general term to define sensitivity. Like in sensitivity, it is only linear, but in transfer function, you can have linear, or you can also have non-linear readings. That's also possible. Okay. Now I'll tell you why do we need to study this. Okay. Okay. I'll just tell you in basics. If I want to tell you what do you mean by transfer function, first of all, transfer function is denoted by G of S. Okay. How it is denoted? It is denoted by G of S. And transfer function is nothing but output to input ratio. Now I'll tell you what is this S. We will come to it later, but G is nothing but a transfer function. So if I write a block, this is my G of S. Okay, there will be some output and there will be some input, okay, into the system. Okay, this will be my input and this will be my output. Now I'll tell you output is represented by Y, input is represented by U. Okay, S is a variable. I'll tell you what is an S. It is actually something which we have studied in maths, which is called as Laplace. I'll tell you what it is. But before that, what we are going to see is output is represented by Y. So if S is the variable in which we are going to write the equation, mathematical equation is in Laplace. I'll just tell you what is Laplace, okay? That is in S variable, okay? Mathematical equation is in Laplace, and Laplace in itself is an algebraic equation. What does the Laplace do? I'll tell you, Laplace converts differential equations of any nature to algebraic equation. Remember this. What is the function of Laplace? Laplace converts differential equation into algebraic equation. Suppose there is one differential equation, and if we want to convert it into algebraic equation, we need to use a variable called as S. That's why that is called as Laplace. It converts any differential equation of any nature into algebraic equation so that it can be solved easily. Why do we convert? To solve easily. Differential equation solution is not that easy, but algebraic equation solution becomes easy. So that is the reason we convert any differential equation into Laplace equation. And that Laplace variable is called as S. That is actually a space variable. I can write it. That is actually a space variable. But even if you don't understand that you convert any differential equation, okay, into an algebraic equation which whose variable is S. Now, this equation, which is actually a mathematical equation, will be nothing but a transfer function. Okay, so the transfer function is represented in terms of S. But if you try to understand, transfer function is obtained from output and input. So if I want the transfer function to be in S, the output and the input should also be in, very nice, it should also be in S. That's why I'll write it again for you and try to make it simplified. I'll just write it. Okay, if I want transfer function to be in S, that means my output should also be in S and my input should also be in S. I'll tell you, okay, this all things are now Laplace. Okay, easy. Okay, so out transfer function is output upon input, then it means it is Y of S upon G of S. If I write it in the block, this is my processing, this is my output, and this will be my input. Okay, so if I want to write transfer function, it will be nothing but Y of S upon U of S. But in initial terms, when we are going to see a system, it will not have Y of S, it will have Y will be some differential equation, output will be some differential equation, input will also be some differential equation in some another variable. Okay, this differential variable will be in some
equation will be in some another variable. Okay, we need to convert this differential equation in any variable into a Laplace equation. Okay, when we convert it into Laplace equation, automatically y, which is in any variable, okay, which is a differential equation, will get converted into linear equation, algebraic equation, y of s, u, which is a differential equation. If we try to convert it into Laplace, it will get converted into u of s. Similarly, y of s upon u of s will give us a transfer function in s, which is just g of s. Simple? Okay. Now, I'll introduce one more thing. This system, where we are going to implement this knowledge of transfer function for our thing, it is a linear time invariant system. Just try to understand what I'm trying to say. First of all, it is a linear system. It is time invariant, matlab it does not change with respect to time. So our system will be LTI system. Which kind of system? Our system, where we are going to implement this transfer function in our syllabus, it will be more like linear time invariant system. It will not vary with respect to time, and this system will be linear in nature. This is the place where we are going to find the transfer functions. Okay, so I'll tell you how to find transfer function. I have already told you the definition of transfer function. Okay, now I'm going to tell you steps to find transfer function. Very easy. Okay, steps to find transfer function. Okay, I'll just put the first step. First of all, write the governing equation. Okay, of the system that is given to you. Very simple. Write the governing equation. It might be in differential form. It might be in integral form. It might be in any form. We don't care about it. But first of all, we need to understand that whatever is the governing equation, we need to write it. Okay. Then, after writing the governing equation, okay, we need to identify, we need to write the governing equation of the system. Okay. Write the governing equation of the system for, I'll write it again, write governing equation of system input. Okay, this points can be bifurcated into two points. First point is write governing equation of system input. Okay, whatever is the input, write the governing equation. It might be in integral form, differential form, we'll see later, but what is important, write the governing equation of system input. Similarly, write the governing equation of, what is that? System output. Very nice. Okay, next, if we have written the governing equation of system input and system output, okay, after this two step, we need to take the Laplace, take Laplace transform of system input equation. Similarly, take the Laplace transform of system output equation that you have formed. Whatever is the governing equation, in whatever nature it is, convert it into Laplace transform. Okay. Now, after you have converted into Laplace transform, whatever might be the governing equation of system input and system output, it must have got converted into S variable, right? It gets converted into S variable. Now, take the ratio of Laplace transform of output, right? Take the ratio of take ratio of, what should be the ratio output to input? To take ratio of Laplace transform of output to Laplace transform of input.
what will this give us? This will give us what? Transfer function, right? It's so simple. So what do we need to do? If we remember, first step is, what is the first step? Write the governing differential equation of output. Second step, write the governing differential equation of input. Third step, convert it into Laplace. Fourth step, convert this into Laplace. Okay? Convert this into Laplace. Next, take the ratio of output to input. Simple. To find what? G of s, which is nothing but y of s upon u of s. Simple. Okay? Now, I'll just give you an example to understand how do you actually form a transfer function. Okay? Now, I'll just take an example. Suppose there is a system which is having some resistance, then it is having some inductance. I hope I am clear with the diagram. This is my resistance. Then suppose this is my inductance. Okay, and suppose there is a capacitance. Okay, and suppose this is my voltage, input voltage. Okay, I'll just write it. Input voltage is a time variable. Okay, current is also a time variable. If you remember, that if there is a voltage, input voltage, there will be some current, input voltage of some frequency. It will be okay. Okay, input voltage of some frequency, there will be a current into the system. That will also be a time variable. This is my resistance. This is my inductance. This is my capacitance. Okay, and I am going to measure my output across the capacitance. I can measure my output across the resistance, inductance, or capacitance. In this case, I am going to measure my output across capacitance because this is a variable of time. Current is a variable of time. Automatically, my output will also be a variable of time. Okay, now I have got this system. I have to write the transfer function for this. Okay, what I have to do is write transfer function. Okay, now if we remember to write the transfer function, what was the first step? If we can remember, what was the first step? Governing equation of input. Okay, we need to write governing equation of system. I'll just write it here. System input. Now we need to see what is the input. What is the input if we can see? I'll just change the color for your simplicity. What is the input? Input is Vi of t. Governing differential equation, system input, governing equation of system input, if we want to write, we know that V is equal to IR, correct? The first thing will be if Vi we need to find, voltage we need to find, which is nothing but input voltage in terms of time t, okay, which is a variable. This is not into t. This is Vi, which is a function of t, will be equal to I of t into R, perfect, plus if we need to write L, we already have studied it in PWE that L will be there, but this will get into differential form. This will be a derivative. What will be the derivative? Di by dt. And this I is nothing but a function of t. Don't get this t cancelled, okay? This is a function. Di of t divided by dt. And for C, we know that this is an integral. So this will be more like 1 by C integral of I of t dt. I hope this is clear. We all know because we have studied Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. We have studied inductance law, which is nothing but V is equal to di by dt into L. And if we study capacitance law, C is equal to, rather than L in numerator, we will have C in denominator. And I will now become a function of t, but it is in integral form. Okay. So we have got the governing differential equation in terms of, I'll write it again, differential equation, or you can say governing equation of system input is I of t into R plus L of di of t by dt plus 1 upon c integral I of t dt. Now we need to write second step. What is the second step? Governing differential equation, or sorry, rather than using word differential, governing equation of system output. Now we need to see where are we measuring our output. If we can see, we are measuring our output only at one place. What is that place? We are measuring our output across the capacitance, right? We are measuring our output across the capacitance. Can you see? Okay, we are measuring our output across the capacitance. So if I tell you to write V output, okay, it will be equal to, what is the governing differential equation, or what is the equation for this? Simple, we just did it now, 1 by C, can we see it? This is the differential equation. So this will be 1 by C integral I of t dt, simple. So we have got a simple way of writing the governing equation for system output. What is that governing equation for system output? It will be V naught of t, but this will be equal to 1 by C I of t dt. Okay, so now we have got both the equations. What is the next step? If we can remember, can anyone tell me? Yep. What is the next step? Converting. Third step is converting it. System input, if you want to write system input, to Laplace transform. Okay, so first I'll write system input again. Very fast I'll write it. Vi of t is equal to I of t r plus l di of t by dt plus 1 by c integral of I of t dt. Okay, now if I convert it into s, this will become vi of s. Okay, this will be a variable, rather than in time we will have a variable in s. Now if I convert it into s, I will also become I of s r. R is a constant, L is a constant, d by dt. Can you see d by dt? D by dt in Laplace gets transformed into, if we can remember, d by dt of Laplace gets transformed into s. I of s will be as it is, t ke jage we will get s. Now 1 by c is constant, integral of dt gets transformed into 1 by s. And I of t will be again I of s. So this is the conversion. Simple. We have converted into it into Laplace. If you remember the Laplace that we have done in maths, d by dt becomes s. Okay, Laplace transform I am taking. And integral of dt will become I of s. Sorry, 1 by s. I of t will be similar I of s. Vi of t will become Vi of s. Now, if we write output, the fourth step was, again, converting system input. And I can also write system output. Okay, I'll just add on the system and system output to Laplace transform. So if I want to convert V naught of s, it will be what? Like, this is my V naught of s. If you remember V naught of t, what was V naught of t? 1 by c integral I of t dt. So what I'll write here is V naught of s will be equal to 1 by c constant 1 by s I of s. Simple. Now, if we remember the last step, we need to find the transfer function, right? So, the transfer function is given by, g of s, which is nothing but y of s upon u of s. Now, if I want to write y of s and u of s, I know that this will be my V naught of s is nothing but, this is nothing but y of s, and this is nothing but u of s, right? So I'll write it here, y of s is 1 by c s I of s upon, what I'll write is I of s into r plus l s I of s again 1 by c s I of s. Simple.
Now, what do we need to do? Can we see I of s common? Yes, we can see. I'll just change the color. Can you see I of s, I of s, I of s, I of s? Taking it out common and multiplying and dividing, or you can say directly eliminating. So g of s will be equal to 1 by cs upon what we are getting, r plus ls plus 1 by cs. Now I'll try to simplify this. 1 by cs will be as it is. This will be rcs and lcs square plus 1 upon cs. Now cs and cs will get cancelled. What will remain out of this is, what will remain out of this is, g of s will be equal to 1 by rcs plus lcs square plus 1. So this is my transfer function. I hope everyone understood. And this is nothing but y of s upon u of s will be equal to this value, correct? 1 upon rcs plus lcs square plus 1. So if I want to write transfer function the way I wrote it, that same system can be converted into some output, some input, right? And a g of s, which is nothing but 1 upon rcs plus lcs square plus 1. This is my g of s. So what have we done? This y of s is v naught of s. This u of s of is vi of s. So what we have done right now is we have converted a electrical system. What we have done here is we have converted an electrical system. Okay. Into a transfer function block. Okay. We have converted an electrical system basically into a transfer function. Simple as that. I hope you understood whatever I was trying to explain. Okay. I'll give you another example of transfer function because we need to understand it more properly. We need to understand how it's functioning. Okay. I'll just give you another example. Suppose we have a differential equation, okay, mathematical equation. I'll just give you one mathematical equation. And by looking at it, we can identify what kind of mathematical equation this is. Okay, d3y by dt cube plus 10 d2y by dt square minus 5 dy by dt plus y, okay, is equal to 10 du by dt plus u. Okay, and we need to find its Laplace transform. Can we find its Laplace transform? Yes. We know that y for us is output, u for us is input, and we know what to do with d by dt. So if I want to write the Laplace transform, this is a governing differential equation. It has output as well as input. Governing differential equation with output and input. If we can see, y is output and u will be input. Okay. So if I want to write Laplace transform, how can I write it? Just remember the basic things that I have taught you right now. D cube by dt cube. Okay. D3 by dt cube will have 3s. So it will be s cube. Y will get converted into y of s. Then 10 will be constant. D2 by dt square will be s square. Y will get converted into y of s minus 5. D1 by dt1 will be equal to single s. Y will again get converted into y of s plus y. Since there is only y, this will be only y of s, will be equal to 10. D by dt again will be s, and this will be u of s. Again, sirf only a single u, that's why it will be u of s. Now what I can do here is, can I take y of s common? Yes.
So y of s is common. What will remain is s cube plus 10 s square minus 5 s plus 1. Okay, will be equal to, we will take u of s common from her. Here u of s will be equal to 10 of s plus 1. So if I write y of s divided by u of s, it will be 10 s plus 1 upon s cube plus 10 s square minus 5 s plus 1. This will be my, if you can see, this will be my g of s, because y of s upon u of s is nothing but g of s. So any differential equation can be written in the form of transfer function, okay, which will have, simple, any differential equation can be written in the form of transfer function. What is our transfer function right now? 10 s plus 1 upon s cube plus 10 s square minus 5 s plus 1. Remember, this is not a typical term. This is just your governing differential equation. If you can remember, we converted it from governing differential equation. Okay. So any governing differential equation can be converted into Laplace. Why do we do this thing? Because we know that this system is simple. You'll understand how to solve this kinds of system. Okay. You can actually find various values without solving typical governing differential equations. Okay. Okay, so I hope these things were clear. And what you have learned today is, you have learned what do you mean by a transfer function. I have already taught you what do you mean by an open loop system and a closed loop system. So I have in detail explained you what do you mean by transfer function, how do you, what do you mean, okay, meaning of transfer function. Second, I have taught you how to find a transfer function. Third, I have taught you what is actually interpretation of transfer function. This is nothing but whatever is written in the block is actually whatever is written in the block, whatever was there, like LC S square plus RC S plus 1. This was nothing but this was actually electrical system, okay, which was converted into a transfer function. This is a basic mathematical. This is also a governing differential equation, okay, integral differential equation. It was having both the types. Integration was also there and differential terms were also there. This electrical system was having all the terms, basic algebraic terms, integral terms and differential terms. And this system was having what? This system, if you can look at this, this system was having what? This was having linear algebraic also, differential also, but this was not having integral. The earlier part was also having integral. So similarly, what are we going to do in the next coming lectures is, we are actually going to find the transfer functions, whatever is going to be there in your system from now onwards. Okay. From now onwards, what are you going to see in the control system? You are going to control the system with the help of a, you are going to control systems with the help of a transfer function. And transfer function is not a layman kind of a term. Transfer function is converting a differential equation into an algebraic equation. Converting a differential equation into an algebraic equation. But this differential equation will have an algebraic equation in S. Okay, which is a space variable. We don't care bother much about space variable. We should know, we do it for the simplicity. And we can convert a complicated system into a single block. A very single block. And this single block will give us the ratio of output to input. Simple. I hope this was very clear for you all, and thank you so much for being so attentive.